Hello. I'm assuming this is probably best played on a controller. It's a game I had already a half wiped off my backlog. But this morning I figured, you know what? It's probably a short one. Probably at least a bit sneaky. I could go for something like that. It's been a while. Why not? Hey, Marger. Depending on how long this turns out to be, I can play something else afterward. That's nice. Oh, already in control. I was expecting the game to give me some some info on the controls as I go, but then I'm best off checking. Sprint, grab, glider, jump. Look around. So the glider is controlled with right stick, at least to a degree. That's not much of a sprint, is it? I see. No, I don't have the DLC. I figured I'd rather do the main game first and then see if I even want to do the DLC. That's a nice touch. When you're sprinting, the little guy covers the lighter with his hand. Oh, you can just pick up anything. This is coming with me, I suppose. Oh, somebody behind the door. Hello. Also, I haven't played Limbo, so don't know much about that one. Hang on. I have questions about how he hanged himself. How did he end up that high up when the chair is this low? Sure, he might be hanging from the pipes, or, I mean, from that thing over there. But the chair didn't help him, did it? Sure, maybe. Like the implication of the chair was a bit different, but not quite functional. Maybe I shouldn't question his chosen method of suicide, though. Checkpoints. Jesus Christ. Yeah, even fall. Air, I guess. I thought I would die right there. Quite mean. The reset was a bit faster. Kind of discourages experimentation. I assume I have to do something with the door. Doing it right. No. Oh. So far, I'm maybe a tiny bit surprised by how interactive things are. I thought this would be mostly just hold a direction type of game, but actually have to press things, press a button to hold on to things and such. But it's already more gameplay than I expected, which not necessarily saying a whole lot. Hey, it's a good thing. Yeah, it not being too long is a prime reason to why I chose to play it today. What? Did I die? Did the door crush me? I guess so. Any point in doing this. Dark? I haven't. Play bathroom. Gain points game. Probably have it, but haven't played it. Don't tell me I have to platform across here. Third one in the same genre?
Eh.
I don't feel like this is exactly my genre. Giving it a shot, but... I don't expect to be playing many games like this. Oh, you have at least some form of stamina system here. climbable? No, but that over there looks climbable. Like, I feel like if I'm gonna play another game like this, then I'll probably play like Limbo or Inside. Not because they speak to me on a personal level or anything, but because they are at least somewhat popular and highly regarded. And short, yeah. I don't think I want to play something like Abe's Odyssey or something. So I believe those games are actually quite lengthy. And I don't think I would want to play this for 15 hours. Design though. Where am I going? I can't climb on this thing. Okay. Like, this appears to be quite a bit of trial and error. Okay, it's doing the same thing as Bale Frame was doing. Where your controller vibrates to your heartbeat. That's nice. I think that's one of the few good uses of vibration. So not sprinting doesn't work. Right now I'm getting the sense that there is exactly one correct solution to this. Just gonna have to figure it out through trial and error. And it would be nice if I could see myself, so Like, we try to hide under a bed. So it can smell me? Is that the gimmick? Can't climb on that. I didn't think I would make a sound, even while not sneaking, but I guess I do. At least there was no audible sound. It's about the same volume, I think, regardless of my movement speed. But okay. I'll sneak into future. Yes, I'm hungry. Pass me some food, mate. I was expecting something a bit more mean-spirited, like eating it in front of me. Other news. Nice. Why I'm lighting these, then I can. Uh-huh. was somehow expecting this to smash through something. Isn't. I can't lower it again, can I? No. Oh. I don't have to hold the switch, that would explain it. Same button to grab the lid and climb up. It's a bit awkward. Oh, okay. Cannot grab onto the rope. I thought it would lift me up. Where the hell am I? Oh, you gotta be fucking kidding me. Seriously? Oh, never mind. Power is off, so I can go through here. Wasn't a huge progress loss. I guess I just somewhat sequence broke my way down there. Achievement unlocked. Prison. It was chapter one of I don't know how many. God. That's why I don't play 2D platforms a lot. Walking up the stairs seems like a trivial task, but I still fail at it. Although, in my defense, this is more like 2.5D. It is possible to move to the stairs. Okay, what do I want to do with this key, though? Out. Oh, I was hoping I could throw it off the foreground. I was trying to pull that, but I guess that's not a thing. Hold A to throw it. Okay. Amnesia bunker update, right? Not anytime soon, I don't think. Still too fresh in my mind. But I would want to do another playthrough. You know, I kind of might hate that game a bit, for as good as it is. Oh right, this is an elevator. Stupid. Although I don't feel like I'm gonna forget anytime soon how that game progresses. Or how the layouts are. Or most of the things. In fact, the one thing I think I won't remember is the layout of that one area I never went to. Everything else is probably gonna stick with me for a good while. Especially since most of the areas in that game are reasonably small, so... Or all around that game is reasonably small, so there isn't really much to forget. Okay, can I eat the dead rat? No, get captured over there. Walk to the rat trap. Also, as it is, my backlog is absolutely filled with horror games. Horror games that I have not played before. I'd rather take a look at those first. Okay, the Silent Hill games. Still gotta get around to those. Most Resident Evils as well. Cursed Mountain is actually kinda on my buy list. If I see a cheap copy, I will pick it up. But I can't play it right now because my capture setup for Wii and PS2 is too crap. And yeah, Wii. Platform of choice. I wasn't actually aware of it being on PC, but I somehow have a feeling that it might not run too well on PC. The simple fact that I never hear anybody mention the PC version, and I wasn't aware of it myself until this very moment, kind of makes me wonder how good of a port that is. Or how good of a game that is. In general, nobody bothers to mention that little fact. Oh, EU only. Well, still. Especially on PC. PC, EU. EHA only. You didn't really make a difference. I Yeah, I haven't forgotten. I just haven't actually looked into it. I know it's a game that exists, and it's a game I'm curious to try. It's a game I'm aware of. I have still not played any Silent Hills outside from times I streamed 1 and 2. Those are the only two times I have played any Silent Hills. But technically, I tried to play 3 at one point, but I didn't make it anywhere in it. Just, I think there was some puzzle that just made me stop. Like, yeah, this is stupid. I'm done. And it was very early on in the game. Somehow I have a feeling it's probably not worth it. I still have every other Silent Hill to do. Before I can even consider Book of Memories, I gotta get through the classics of Downpour and Homecoming. What do you want from me, game? And in general, there's so much stuff on PS2 that I just gotta get around to. I'm glad I finally played through Fatal Frame. That was a surprisingly good one. Sprint this time. Last time I had to go slow, this time I had to go fast. I must say, I am not sold on the gameplay. Little Nightmares.
honestly.
Oh, I can't climb up this? Stuck here now. He's also stuck. I think I broke it. Close the door. Oh, it just kept opening for way longer than I pushed the lever. Nice to know. Hey, Ragnar. Yes. It barely makes a difference, but yes. Hey, that's a cool little set piece. Kind of like the Amnesia water monster. I remember this sequence from Half-Life Alyx. Are you for real? How did you reach me? Thank you. Like, the first time I encountered this enemy, the game specifically wanted me to sneak past him. And the second time, the game wanted me to run past him. And now I'm getting punished for running again. Like, the game can't decide what is the preferred approach. I feel like I should have made it both times. And the weird thing is that this game does have, at least to a degree, like, not just fully scripted moments, but a reactive AI. Because this guy did behave differently in that one sequence. He was trying to follow me. Oh, now I'm supposed to just stand here and... okay. Yeah, the game wants me to follow a script. It's bad for me because I'm not somebody who likes to follow scripts. Nice thing is that the character actually does look around. If it doesn't seem like there's anything to interact with, the character still focuses on the thing. Always nice when games do that. Oh, you can break those! I've seen like 5 of them before, but north because I didn't know how to interact with them. Oh, that's probably like break all of these and you get an achievement, I think. Oh, there's a hole over there. Okay, he does have rather long reach. Maybe his arms are stretchy by design. Now, if that was the case, it would be great if his arms reached out into this this pipe right now. you get over here already? More fast. Okay. Come on. Can't climb over those. Script. So I was able to at least somewhat skip part of that, I think. Didn't have to hide on the clocks. Nice timing. Nice timing. I almost made an effort there to time that right. I'm not confident in my platforming. Attacking by pushing the monkey on him. Somehow I doubt it. Oh, I'm still alive. Unexpected. That actual stealth gameplay right there. Full on distractions. Why did I climb up here? Oh, because there's a hole right there. I mean, the main reason why I climbed up here was because I could. This is not throwable, it seems. There's a checkpoint in here somewhere. At least this time I knew that the crank would keep going even if I let go of it. So I felt confident in just getting away from there sooner. Oh, nice. Health. Thanks, game. Oh, come on. You're gonna do that again? Oh, come on. That's mean. Hey, Blackers. Don't let go. There. Get your arms crushed. For fun. I feel like that's gonna break any second. I'm just surviving for a while until things happen. I'm not sure anything is gonna happen. I assume I have to do something with the cage over there that's being crushed. I can grab it. Yeah, there we go. Okay, so this is a boss fight. No, I couldn't grab it. There we go. Thank you. Okay, another achievement, which I assume means this was chapter 2. Anybody know how many chapters this game has? Or levels, or whatever they are called? Five chapters? Okay, that's not too bad. Means we're approaching the halfway mark. It is a nice looking game though, I will give it that. Now eat the rat. The hands make it seem like that's the plan. That's much leftovers? Dude, come on. You were so hungry just now. Barely took a bite. I like his design. Actually has a similar mouth as some of the characters from World of Horror. seems like the enemies are very reactive to sound. And walking is very loud. Okay. I didn't make a sound, but... sure. Yeah, that makes more sense. He reacted a bit slowly to the gnome, so I assume that those don't technically make a sound. Suppose they do. No idea what the gnome is gonna do, but I'm sure it's not gonna be good for me. Yeah, no reaction to that. Two posts. I was trying to be so careful with that. Nope. Lots of toilets in this game. Oh, I like that. Oh, look at that. I've seen a picture of toilet right there. You're gonna come back? Surely he didn't go for a shit. That's a hiding place. Oh yeah, this toilet indeed is, quite the design. Wait, can I really not go back through here? No, I cannot. I'm back. You didn't have to hold down the button to hold on to the item. My old fingers are getting tired. Die on me. I'm gonna kill somebody with this. Well, that's disappointing. Okay, I'm gonna need way more meat. So I am gonna kill somebody with this. Just drop one of these things in. Well, I was really hoping to kill one of the chefs with that. can grab onto that. Any more meat somewhere? Not that I can see. Try to get that big one over there. Maybe if I can swing in a different direction. Nope. Not even, doesn't even have a collision. Those are some dense sausages. Yeah, the style is really good, and it does have a occasional really neat set pieces, or nifty looking rooms work well within that style. Could have pocket cheese. Come on. Never know when you need it. Although I'm not sure he has pockets. More concerning. Why did I do that? I don't really know. I could. I need to use that hook on the left side of the screen and grab onto the chef. Figure out how to operate it. Climbing up that. Oh, I haven't been through here, so this doesn't seem to lead to anywhere though. Oh, I could see through his head. Oh, art style ruined. Can't climb up here either. Where do you want me to go, game? Oh, there's a key right there. Don't remember where the keyhole is, but I have a key now. Or I have an access to a key.
Hi.
I just have to assume that the keyhole is somewhere downstairs. Where else would I go? I didn't do what I was hoping to do, but that worked. Well, we won't find about the brain now. It might just not do anything. I didn't even notice a train. Oh, it definitely didn't strike me as a threat. I'm just going right. Yeah, and also cough on the dishes a lot. Important part of the process. Thank you for not hitting the switch again. You probably did something I want to do. I assume I have to climb on a pile of dishes to get high enough. I'll be disappointed if I can climb up those fuses. I'm overcomplicating this for myself. Maybe I am not. Gotta be a place in here that I can climb up. Like that pile of fishes, maybe. Maybe further back. What? Slow-paced game. Slower than I anticipated. It's funny because I had two choices on what would I play this morning. It was between this and Alien vs. Predator. Two games very similar in pace. Yeah, I mean, I know there are people who really like AVP as well. Does it feel sneaky? Honestly, it doesn't. That's pretty disappointing. I feel like a big part of feeling sneaky is that it has to have at least a bit of agency, right? Don't think I really have in this. Hi. Oh. Okay, you can do that. This feels like I'm just solving a puzzle. It doesn't feel like I'm being sneaky, which often can be very similar things. even in more stealthy stealth games, you are often just solving a puzzle, but it feels more stealthy as you do it. Which is why I've been using that as my definition for a stealth game, as it feels stealthy, and this one doesn't. AVP 1999. Which is a classic shooter. Although I think so, AVP 2 is a more classic shooter, but... you know, that's available nowhere. Oh yeah, not 2010. ...1999 and AVP2 are the ones I have interest in. Also, that was the end of the chapter. And I guess the third option was finally get it over with and start Half-Life. I'm gonna play a shooter and then... can you go wrong with Half-Life? This is a pretty new visual look for this game. Visual look, as opposed to the other types of looks. Ugh. Dear God. Well, do it again. I'm kind of with people who are not interested in fighting monsters and stuff like that. So that's almost always the least interesting part of any horror game. This is also not the gameplay I wish to replace the combat. I feel like I've recently played some pretty good horror games that don't have any combat or even enemies. I would have to look at my list. To see what I'm referring to, but I'm sure there are some. First thing to come to mind is in the style of... I don't know why this comes to mind, but the Unsorted Horror was pretty good with some of the things it did. But absolutely no threats, it was all scripted, but you still felt like you had to think while playing. Honestly, the most... In case of this, it's trying to be, or rather, it is spooky with the aesthetic and monster designs and all that, but it doesn't make me really think much. It doesn't make my heart race. The muscle that is the most sore from playing this is my index finger, because I have to hold down the action button so much. Exciting nor, I don't know, thought-provoking might be the wrong word here, but it doesn't require me to think on any, I don't know, engaging level. Yeah, but the atmosphere isn't landing either, because so much of this is trial and error, and that does horrible things to atmosphere. Yeah, I don't think it's scary. The same reason why it doesn't feel stealthy. Like, I don't feel like I have any agency here. I'm just following the script. Like, you know, in both stealth and horror, you get those moments where you need to move from A to B. And before you do it, you have to carefully consider, is this the right move? What could happen if things go wrong? Should I prepare in some way? And really plan your actions. Here I don't really, because my action is either right or wrong, and I'll find out by trying. Nothing I can do to prepare for it. There is no plan B if I fail. I'm just following the script. Can I use you as bait? I give you a hug so now you're following me. That's probably the right action, I just didn't do it correctly. Can I climb up the sausage? That'd be great. No. Are you for real? Kinetic hands are pretty annoying. Am I not supposed to grab onto that? I couldn't climb on the pot on the back either. Where do you want me to go from here? That looks climbable. I can't think of any other way to go. All right. Just failing to jump. See me? You can. more toilets. Three in a row. And one for the king. I think the mirror is causing frame rate issues. Can I break it? Good. I think the best bathroom setup I have seen in any game, which I eventually want to see personally when I play it, is in Resident Evil 4. Where I believe there is a bathroom with nothing but a sink. Has to take place in America. Has to. Americans on a cruise to Japan. Again, you just took one bite. Come on. Eat a bit more and you don't have to eat again soon. I think we're on to the last chapter. That was a reasonably short one, I think. lock. Note it. Aha. My favorite type of stealth. Barefoot in broken glass. Come on. If John McClane did it, why would you not? Nice throw. Okay, so now she's not into killing me. Seems important. I can't hide under the chair. I don't even know if this is supposed to be a mirror because it doesn't have a reflection. Oh. Also, I do not understand what this part is trying to tell me. Want me to take this mirror? Oh. Okay. The light. Okay. See the light the first time around, so difficult to solve this. Oh, am I gonna eat her? But just one bite. Let's not be greedy. I was the nightmare all along. And now go and back to the boat and eat everybody there. That would be a twist. Or be eaten. Okay, that was shorter than I expected. I thought it would be like 3 to 4 hours. Maybe I will play AVP after all. Yeah, there's DLC, but I'll pass. AVP by whoever made it in 1999. Yeah, not to beat him up. I just picked it up yesterday and confirmed that it seems to work just fine on modern systems, without any mods. First, we're gonna do a recap on this. When the creeps eventually end. AVP2 sadly isn't available anywhere, as far as I can tell. As tends to be the case with anything made by that studio from that era. Studio's name escapes me right now. Forever, Condemned People, Monolith, yeah. Oh no, now we're getting the Bandai Namco credits. Oh boy! I wonder if these people actually worked on this game to any capacity, or if they just happened to be working at Bandai Namco at the time. How long are these credits? Okay, they're starting with QA here, so presumably they're not listing the entire organization. Remember, made it to special thanks, that's a good thing. Thank you. These are like Ubisoft credits. Just keep going. Basement is a different chapter. Oh no, these are DLCs. Right. Three DLCs. Right. Don't be touching those. Oh. Nice thing. They actually list all the things. Hugged gnomes and smashed statue. Of it. That wasn't in the game. That's all I got. Nice. Cool. Adult planters didn't seem to do anything. We take a look at the achievement, see if they say something about lanterns. I mean, these don't seem to elaborate much on what you need to do to get them. Oh well. You do hear operating music. Don't feel like I have a lot to say about this one. Finished, yes. About 2.5 hours. I will not tap felt sneaky for this one, unfortunately. Very nice looking art style. How do I describe the gameplay? Anything else to say about this, really?
honestly didn't notice them. And the same with the puzzles. It was just do the thing you can do.
That's all I can really say, I think. I guess it's a positive that it was shorter than I expected. AVP? I think that's also a pretty short game, but I don't know. I've also heard that it's quite a hard game. Refresh this page somehow? I don't actually know. Something's matter. Yeah. There we go. AVP, 1999. Okay, I'll take a short break. Stretch my legs. Grab a snack. My water bottle. And then I suppose we'll start Alien vs. Predator. Be back shortly.